Look at the likes of Tahir White. The individual has a chair in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam masjid. But look at his mistakes. Calling the nation of Islam my brothers and working and interacting with them. And you have this fool that was in Medina too, Shadid Muhammad. He said that on Friday I had my shirt, Black Lives Matter. Hizbiya, straight up. Here, he say, tweet, this is his own words. I'm happy today, on Friday, on my thobe, over my thobe, I have my t-shirt that say Black Lives Matter. That's not Hizbiya. No, five real, not only for real, five real. Hizbiya. You don't think that's Hizbiya? Okay, we were not created to defend blacks or whites, Fula, Wolof, Senegalese, Gambians, Sarah. No, we were not created for that. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا خَلَاص. That's it. Anyone that is calling to other than this, this is completely outside of the narration. The Shaykh Hafidhahu Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, he mentioned, he say, وَمَا هَلَكَتِ الْأُمَّةِ إِلَّا بِمِثْلِ هَذَا. He said that the Ummah has been destroyed except, meaning Umam, other nation has been destroyed except the likes of these. Except the likes of these. وَهُوَ أَنَّهُمْ عَظَّمُوا آثَارُ كَبَائِرِهِمْ حَتَّى صَارَتْ أَوْثَانًا فِي الْمُسْتَقْبِلِ. He said that you find people, they will be building and they will be raising as monuments طيب, the landmarks of the kibar, of the elders, or of the chiefs, or the heads, until those places became what? Became a idol. And they went ahead and worshipped them fil mustaqbil, in the long run. He say, fal wajib ala al muslim. This is what is incumbent upon the Muslim. At tanbih li hadha al amr. To be barakallahu fikum, stressing on this issue. To be cautious about this issue. And to be paying much attention about this issue. Don't just say that alhamdulillah, I'm free from shirk. What you are guaranteed, and we are not even barakallahu fikum. Akhi, the majority of the people, those who ascribe to Islam, majority of them, they commit shirk. Majority of them commit shirk. Majority of them commit shirk. Majority of them commit khurafat, superstitions. The majority of the Muslims, they are upon innovation. When the mawlud of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam come, that it is a minority that are not celebrating it. It is a tiny bitty minority that is not celebrating it. A very small amount of people that are not celebrating. But the majority, they are celebrating it. Let's ask ourselves where we're from. That on the time of the Mawlud, you will find almost the whole country is shut down based on an innovation. Now look how innovation can have an evil effect on an economy. Now one day the whole economy is shut down. Now think about if you have many days like this throughout the year where the economy is shut down. No buying or no selling. Now do you think that these people, they will barakallahu fikum, they will have some type of development, having progress in the economy? And this is why, akhi, look at those countries where innovation is very spread, except that they are countries where the economy is going down every single day. Going down and down to the ground every single day. So the Shaykh Hafidhahu Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, he said, وَذَكَرَ الشَّيْخ شَاهِدًا لِذَلِكَ. And the Shaykh Hafidhahu Allah Ta'ala, he gave example of this statement that he mentioned as far as taking the landmarks of the elders and building it and then to be taking it, barakallahu fikum, and seeking barakah of it. And he gave the example of Darun Nadawa. And he said, this was in Mecca. وَهِيَ مَكَانْ يَجْتَمِعَ فِيهِ أَكَابِرِ قُرَيْشِ. And this was the place where the elders of the Quraysh, they used to be coming to meet. لِتَشَاوِرِ فِي أُمُورِ الْمُهِمِ. He said that this was the place where the elders of the Quraysh, they used to come to sit around. So they will have this type of dialogue between them for those matters that was important matters. So they can, barakallahu fikum, have a munaqasha, or they have a tashawur, they have this meeting in regard to those matters that are important matters. فلما جاء الإسلام وزالت الجاهلية, and when Islam came and the جاهلية was removed. What جاهلية is he talking about here, Abdullah? He say ولما أو فلما جاء الإسلام وزالت الجاهلية. When Islam came and the جاهلية was lifted, what جاهلية is talking about? عام أحسنت. بقي مبنى دار النداوة على حاله إلى وقت معاوية رضي الله عنهم معاوية رضي الله عنه. He said that when Islam came and the Jahiliyyah was lifted, meaning the general Jahiliyyah was lifted, he said these types of buildings or monuments were still remaining upon how they were up until at the time of Muawiyah رضي الله عنه. Muawiyah, who was the father of Muawiyah? The father of Muawiyah. No, not this one. No, this Muawiyah, right? The radiyallahu anhu Muawiyah. Abu Sufyan, naam. Abu Sufyan. Radiyallahu anhuma. So he mentioned, when it remained, meaning the building remained in the structure, up until the time of Muawiyah, Ibn Abu Sufyan, radiyallahu anhuma. May Allah be pleased with both of them, ameen. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide or break the backs of those who speak ill of Muawiyah, ameen. And the rest of the sahaba, ameen. And he say, لِتَمْلِيكِ وَالْإِنْتِفَاعِ بِسُكْنَاهَا. And when Muawiyah radiallahu anhu, he came, yani to own, meaning came, and then he wanted to take it and make a use of it. And he say that he tried to, yani to get it, meaning to get the Darun Nadwa, so to make a use of it. He say, فَاشْتَرَى هَذِهِ الدَّارُ. So he bought the place. He bought the place from the hand of who? From the hand of? No, Muawiyah bought it from the hand of Hakim ibn. Naam, Hakim ibn Hizam. Bismillah. He bought it. Muawiyah bought the Darun Nadwa from the hand of Hakim ibn Hizam. Ahsantum. So therefore, he say, radiyallahu anhu, he say, falamma nasu. He say, فَلَامَ النَّاسُ حَكِيمًا عَلَى ذَلِكَ. So the people, they complained. They complained and they show their displeasure about what Hakim has done in selling their Darun Nadwa to Muawiyah. And they say, بِعْتَ. Before that, he say, قَالُوا لِمَ بِعْتَ هَذَا الْأَثَرِ. Why have you sold this landmark? مِنْ أَثَارِ أَسْلَافِنَا. From those who were the our predecessors? Why did you sell these landmarks, this monument, this building that is a representation of our honor? Why did you sell it? وَبِعْتَ مَكْرَمَةَ قُرَيْشِ. You have indeed sold the honor of the Quraysh. So here they was ascribing the honor of the Quraysh to what? To the Darun Nadwa. But look at the athar of Tawheed. Look at the effect of Tawheed in the hearts of the people of Tawheed. Look at the statement of Hakim ibn Hizam radiyallahu anhu ardah. He say, ذَهَبَتِ الْمَكَارِمِ إِلَّا التَّقْوَى. He say, all honor has left except at-taqwa. He say, all honor has left except at-taqwa. So he was not looking at that building the same way they were looking at it. لِمَاذَا? Because the tawheed of Allah has entered in his heart. He was not looking at this building. That's my ancestor's building. This is the greatest man among the Quraysh building. Why should we sell it? Why shouldn't we keep it? He was not looking at the building like this. In other words, he put the religion of Allah before his own tribe and landmarks. Before anything, barakallahu fikum. Now who among us will do this? Putting Islam, putting the Tawheed, putting Salafiyah before we put forth anything else. لشحفظه الله تبارك وتعالى. He say, وهذا مأخوذ من قوله تعالى. This statement of Hakim ibn Hizam is taken from the statement of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, when he say in Surah Al-Hujurat, إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم. إن أكرمكم عند الله. The most noble among the people with Allah is what? Those who have a taqwa. Now, amma us, the people, we will look at many other things to have for honor. Amma us, human being, we are looking at other things, right, in regard to how honorable a person is. If a person has money, right, we start, man, this is the most honorable among us. And that's the sad reality. In certain places, if you have money, man, you can be the worst of the criminal. They can know you're a dope dealer. No, they don't care about that no more. Man, you are the son of so-and-so. Your father was the one that killed the lion. When everybody in the tribe ran away, your father was the only one that stood up. Now, you know, praising you, wal-iyadu billah. Or even telling you your father was the greatest imam in town. Akhi, your father even didn't know how to read alif and ba. Or your father was the most righteous man. Your father never established the salah in the masjid. Or your father was the best man in town. And he was the one that smoked all the tobacco in the streets. Seriously, because this is what the nobility that we look at.
It's true, man. What you saying? I know. What are 5-6 people, man?
Slow your breaths. So therefore, the honor, barakallahu fikum, it is not as us, we measure it. We will measure, oh, this guy, he has spent many years in Medina University, or many years in Mecca, in Ummul Qura. This is not, barakallahu fikum, how it is. This is not how the measurement of nobility is, or honor is. But rather, Allah Jalla, he said, inna akramakum inda Allah, the one that has more nobility within among you with Allah, is the one that has a taqwa. The one that has more taqwa. But us, we're looking at other things. And Allah Akbar, there's this narration in Sahih al-Bukhari. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, they are among the people. When they will knock at your door for a wife, you will turn them away. No one will vouch for them. But when they raise their hands, the minute they raise their hands, Allah will answer their dua. But when they knock at your door for a wife or for a loan, you turn them away. But when they raise their hands, right away Allah answers, subhanahu wa ta'ala, answer the dua. But we're looking at okay, this individual, he's an, you know, he's, you know,